Was correct now. FIL dollars. So V will be equal to voltage. Let me take voltage because V is used here. I will just say E. V equals E. Voltage. Velocity is equal to voltage. The reason is now I am writing current through the components. When I say current through the components, what is current through the inductance? It is 1 by L integration of V dt, right? Current through the inductor is what? 1 by L integration of E dt. E is nothing but the voltage across the inductor. Okay. So similarly, current through the capacitor is what? C into dV by dt. Yes or no? Okay. So this is what we need to replace it now. So earlier we found voltage across the components. Now we are trying to write current through the components. Okay. So V becomes E, M becomes C. Similarly, K will be 1 by L. B will be 1 by R. 1 by R. This is what the replacement that we do for FIL dollars. Again, I will just recall it. Now, V is replaced with E and M is replaced with C. When I say C into dE by dt, is it not current through the capacitor? K is replaced by 1 by L. V is replaced by the voltage E. Is it not 1 by L integration of E into dt is nothing but current through the inductor? So similarly here, for V2, I am trying to write 1 by R. Why? Because the current through the resistor is what? I equals V by R. Therefore, V should be replaced by 1 by R. Now that is what we are trying to write. Means this is how you remember the replacement of the components without looking into the table. Okay. Now, let us write the analogous equation for the equation 1 of the mechanical system. So, you should go back to the equation and look into the analogous equation here. So, 0 equals M changes with C, so C1 dE1 by dt plus 1 by L1 into integration of E1 dt plus 1 by L2 into integration of E1 minus E2 dt plus 1 by R2 into E1 minus E2 plus 1 by R1 into E1 minus E3. This is your first equation for force current analogous network. Okay. Coming to the next equation for second mechanical equation that we have written. So what do we get? Now force will be equal to what? Current. Because we have current through the component. So the summation of individual currents will be equal to the total current. Therefore F of t will be equal to I of t equals C2 into d into y dt plus 1 by R2 into E2 minus E1 plus 1 by L2 into integration of E2 minus E1 into dt plus 1 by R3 into E2 minus E3. Now this is your second equation for forced current analogous network. Coming to the third equation, force voltage, current analogous equation for this third equation. So what do I get? 0 equals C3 into dE3 by dt plus 1 by L3 integration of E3 dt plus 1 by R3 into E3 minus E2 plus 1 by R1 into E3 minus E1. This is your third equation for force current analogous network. So all three equations are over now. Now by looking into the equation, we need to write the network. Now it's very important. Now earlier we had a mesh currents here. Now you get node voltages. E1, E2, E3 are what? They are three node voltages whatever we have. So what we need to do now for writing the analogous network? We need to write three nodes, right? So three nodes is what? E1, E2, E3, and the reference node is your ground. Okay. Now, what is the components? What are the components which are connected only to E1, C1 and L1? That's it. I don't think so. We have any other component. Therefore, C1 and L1. Any other components for E1? Only E1? See, it should be connected in parallel always. Earlier in mesh analysis, we connected in series. But as it is node voltage analysis, we need to connect this in parallel. Now you can see your L2 is connected between E1 and E2. And also we have R2 which is connected E1 and E2. They both will be in parallel. L2 and then R2. 1 by R2, L2 and 1 by R2, which is connected between E1 and E2. So you can see 1 by R1 is connected between E1 and